ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमसो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते यौपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्य उपव्याख्यानं धरः उत्तरेभ्यः दहरः दहरः दहराकाशः परमेश्वरेव अत्र दहराकाशो भवितुमर्हति दहरा मीन्स् दहरा मीन्स् परमेश्वरः So, the word Dhara or Dharakasha, Dhara stands for Dharakasha. And that it's only right that it should mean Parameshwara. Uttarebhya. On account of the subsequent reasons given subsequently. So, Bhashyakara presents variety of reasons. And Vestavyataya. Abhitasya, Dharakasasya. First of all, clarifying what Dharakasa is, the question was asked that what can there be within that small space which is to be anveshtavyam, which is to be inquired into, vijignasadavyam, which is to be known and realized. Then Sabhruya, then the teachers reply, Yavanva ayam akasha tavanesha antarudaya akasha. As vast in magnitude is this external space, so also is the dhara akasha. Asmin dhyava prithvi antareva samahite. In that dhara akasha are included the heaven, the earth, and the wind and the fire, the wind and the fire, etc. Tatra. Pundarika-dhara-tvena, prap-dhara-tvasya. Since the word dhara is used, which means small, and particularly also the question was that asmin brahmapure dharam pundarikam. Vaishma, dharas means antarakasa. So the lotus itself is very small, and within that there is space which is of course even smaller. And so this description of dharakasa creates the idea that what is to be meditated upon is something very small and insignificant. So what can you meditate? What is there to be meditated upon? And even if there is something to meditate, what is there to be gained? Then to reply, in reply it was said that it is as vast as the external space and that includes the entire universe. So Vasyakara said that since Dharakasa is compared to Bhutakasa, one thing cannot be compared to its own self, therefore Dharakasa is different from Bhutakasa. And Dharakasa, so Bhutakasa, that Akasa, because the traditional meaning or the conventional word Akasa is element space, that is eliminated here. And the Dharatma does not mean smallness, so the smallness also is eliminated. Then the Purupakshi said that same Akasa can be divided into internal and external, and therefore internal Akasa can be compared to external Akasa. Since that is never there, for comparison you do not present the same thing. You present something similar. Okay, but then even this external space cannot be real upama or the standard of comparison for Parameshwara, because Jayan, Akasha, Parameshwara is even greater than the space. So here the Vashyakara says that the purpose of the teacher, to reply of the teacher, is not to say that Dharakasa is as vast as the external space. It is to say that Dharakasa is not small. So that smallness is to be removed. The idea of smallness, so that conclusion has to be removed. Further, Esha Atma, Apahdapatma, the Dharakasa is Atma. The Bhutakasa cannot be because it is Achetanam. And therefore, for Andharakasa to be Atma, it must be a conscious entity. And that also eliminates the idea of Bhutakasa. So reasons first are given. So the question was, thus what Akasa, Dharakasa means Bhutakasa. Elemental space, it cannot be. Because number one, it is compared to elemental space, and one thing cannot be compared to the same thing. And secondly, it is Atma, which is conscious being, the consciousness, and elemental space unconscious there also. Therefore, Akasha cannot mean elemental space. Second was, thus Dharakasha means Jiva. Yadyapi Atma Shabdo Jiva Sambhavati. It is true that the word Atma in this case can mean Jivatma. Tathavi. So even then, for the reasons given, so itarebhya, karanebhya, for other reasons, it is clear that we can show how atdharakasa or atma here cannot mean jivatma. So is atma apahatapatma? So atma, does it mean jivatma or vijnanatma? No, because nahi upadhi parichinnasya aragropamitasya jivasya pundrikaveshanakritam dharatam shaktyam nivartayitam. Even if that jivatma is, so jivatma can be within the heart only when it is small in dimension. Meaning the word dhara or small primarily applies to jivatma. And so dharatma means smallness of the jivatma on account of the small heart being its abode. So it was explained that the jivatma primarily has its look seat in the mind, identified in the mind, and mind is the seat in the lotus of the heart. So jivatma is in the lotus of the heart. If that's what you say, then it remains a small entity. And here with Dharakasha is that which is vast in magnitude. Therefore, if this Dharakasha is Jivatma, then it cannot be equated to the vastness because its smallness cannot be the idea of smallness cannot be eliminated. Brahma Abheda Vaksha Jivasya Sarvagatattvadi Vakshedaiti. Then Purva Pakshi says that, wait a minute. Ultimately, Jivatma is Brahma. And as Brahma, it is vast, it is conscious and everything. So, yad atmadaya jivasya sarvagatattvadi vyakshedha. If Shruti meant Brahma in case of Jiva, for Atma, why should the Shruti not use the word Brahma itself? Or, why should not you interpret as Brahma? Saying that first it means Dharakasha means Jivatma and Jivatma is Brahma. Why did you say that Dharakasha itself is Brahma? So, yada atmataya jivasya sarvagatattvadi vivakshedha. That Jiva is vast, infinite in dimension. Keeping in mind the nature of Jiva is Brahma. Tasya brahmana sakshat sargatattvadi vakshadamiti. Then Shruti should say that Dharakasa is Brahma. Because it is then primarily all pervasive and everything. So why should Shruti say that Dharakasa is Jiva? And then Jiva is Brahma. Instead of that, Shruti can directly say Jivakasa is Brahma. And we are on the page 226, continuing with the fourth line of Bhashya. Says Nyayana in the second line, Brahma Purushabdat Jivopadana Muktam Anuvadati. Brahma, now we come to, so two words were there, Akasha, which created the idea of elemental space, or it could be Parameshwara. Second word was Brahmapuram. Is Brahmapuram the Puram, the city of Brahma or city of Jiva? So Puru Bhakshi said that the city belongs to Jiva. Because it has been acquired by the Jivatma by his own karma. And also, Brahmanapuram, city of Brahma, is primarily the city of Jivatma. And therefore, Brahmapura should mean the city of Jiva. So what Brahma should mean? Jivatma. So, Brahmapura Shabdat, Jiva Upadhanam. Because of Pura, because it is city of Brahma. And the body is known to be the city of Jiva. Therefore, what Brahma there should mean Jiva. That is what the Puru Bhakshi had said. Now Bhashyakara replies to that. Uktam Anuvadati reiterates what the Puru Bhakshi said, and then this idea is refuted. Yadapi, so we read Bhashya. Yadapi Uktam Brahmapuram iti jivena purasya upalakshitatvat rajnya iva jivasya eva idam puraswaminaha puraikadesha vartitvam astu iti yadavi uktam. It is true, it has been said Brahmapuram iti, by the word Brahmapuram, jivena purasya upalakshitatvat. By the word pura is implied jivatma. How? Rajnyaiva jivasya vedam puraswamitvam swaminah. Because the master of a city lives within the city. It is a city belonging to that king. And king is a dwelling place. So since Jiva is a dwelling place in the heart, and this body is acquired by the karma of the jiva. Therefore, Brahmapuram should mean the city of jivatma. Puraswamina puraikadesha vartitvam. Just as the king, who is the master of the city, lives in one part of the city in a palace, so also jiva is the master of the city, which is body, lives in one part, namely the heart. So, Brahmanapuram, Brahmapuram. So now the word Brahmapuram is being analyzed. What should be the meaning? So, Brahmanapuram is the city. Brahmana can mean two things. It is Sambandha Shashti. It means that this Puram and Brahma are related in some way. Or it can mean Sambandha Shashti also can mean the relationship of Swaswami. That it is Brahma is the Swami of the Puram. So Brahma is related to Puram, or Brahma is Swami of the Puram. Both these meanings can be there for the sixth case. Brahmanaha Puram. Brahmana is sixth case. It's called Sambandha Shashti. So number one, there can be some general relationship in Brahma and Puram, or a specific relation of Brahma being master of the Puram. So two interpretations are possible. So now if you look at Ratna Brahma, in the first line, Prathama Shruta Brahma Shabdena Tasapeksha Charama Shruta Shashti Bhaktyartha Sambandhoneya. So Brahma Puram, in that which is the important word, Prathama Shruta Brahma Shabdena, in that the first word that the Shruti mentions is Brahma. So that is the important word, or that entity is important, and that controls the meaning of the word Brahmapuram. So what controls the meaning of the word Brahmapuram? Brahmanaha Puram. So what should be the meaning of the word Brahmanaha? Brahma and Shashti Vibhakti means Brahmanaha. So when you hear Brahmanaha, first you hear Brahma, and then comes the suffix, that is the sixth case. So, Prathama Shruta Brahma Shabdena Tat Sapeksha Charama Shruta Shashti. So, sixth case, which is the Brahmana, should be interpreted based on Brahma. So, Brahma is an important one, primary one. And sixth case, which is suffix, is secondary one. So, secondary one, which is heard later on, which occurs later on, should be interpreted in keeping with the word Brahma. So, Sambandha Shashti. So, Sambandha Neha. The word Brahma Puram means that in some way Brahman is related to the Puram. Nathu Brahmana Puram vidi Shashtyartha Svaswami Bhavagrahya. So, that can be a general relationship or a specific relationship called the Swaswami, the owner and what is on, the possessor and possessed. Also a Sambandha, but a specific Sambandha. So either the word, the sixth case can mean a general relationship between Brahma and Puram, or a specific relationship between the Brahma and Puram as the owner or possessor and what is possessed. So that the Swaswami Bhava restricts the relationship. Brahman can have any relationship with the body by the word Brahmapuram. But when you explain that Shashti as the possessor and possessed, then you are restricting that relationship. So argument is that the relationship should not be restricted to the owner and what is owned. It should be any general relationship. Nirapekshena satat sapeksham bhadhyam. What is nirapeksha? That Brahman is nirapeksha. Therefore, the relationship of Brahman and Puram should be without any condition. If you say relationship is the possessor and possessed, it becomes specific condition. So when nirapeksha means if unconditional relationship can apply, then it is preferable to apply unconditional relationship rather than a conditional relationship. The possessor and possessed is a specific condition. It's a conditional relationship. Whereas there can be other relationships also, which can be unconditional. If unconditional relationship can apply in Sambandha Shasti, then we need not restrict that relationship to the possessor and possessed. So if you say Brahmanapuram, it is city of Brahman, then perhaps Brahma can mean Jiva. It's a city that belongs to Jiva. But if you say Brahmanapuram is city related to Brahma, not possessed by Brahma, related to Brahma, because he is a resident of the city. So he is not the owner of the city, a resident of the city. Then so he is related, you know. You are a guest in the city, whatever. There can be a variety of relationships. So it is not necessary to restrict the relationship to the possessor and possessed. It can be any general relation. That Brahman can be an indweller of the city. As an indweller, it is related to city also. So atra brumaha. So therefore, Bhashyakara says, or as Nyanjana says, namely, prathama shruta brahma shabdena charama shruta vivaktyartha netavyaheti. The sixth case must be interpreted in keeping with the Brahma, rather than Brahma be interpreted in keeping the sixth case. See, if Brahmanapuram is the Swaswami Sambandha, then that Sambandha controls what Brahman means, namely Jiva. But if Brahma controls what the Sambandha is, then it need not be Swaswami Sambandha. It can be any Sambandha. But Brahman is first heard, so that controls what the meaning word Brahmapuram is, because the sixth case suffix comes later. So suffix should not control the meaning word Brahmapuram. It is word Brahma that should control the meaning of the word Brahmapuram. So that's what Bhashyakara says. Atra Brumaha. So this word we have to say. Parasya eva idam brahmanah puram sada shariram brahmapuram ityuchyate brahma shabdasya tasmin mukhyatva. So parasya eva, parasya brahmanah eva, it is param brahma. Idam puram sat, that this body is related to Param Brahma, and therefore it is called Brahmapuram. Idi uchyate. Why? Brahma shabdasya tasmin mukhyatvat. Because then the word Brahman can be interpreted in a primary sense. If the sixth case in terms of Swaswami Sambandha controls the meaning, then what Brahman is interpreted in a secondary sense, namely Jiva. But the Brahma controls the meaning of the word Brahmapuram, then Brahma can be interpreted in a primary sense, which is Param Brahma. So Bhashyakara says, that interpretation, where the word Brahma means Param Brahma, should be the proper interpretation, because when you hear Brahmapuram, what is the first heard? Brahma. So then when your mind says, now it's talking something about Brahma. So what Brahma should control the meaning of the word Brahmapuram, and if he is a Swaswami, then it's not Brahma. General relationship, Brahma is Param Brahma. So therefore, Sambandha Shasti should be not restricted to the possessor and possess, it should be general relationship. Some Sambandha should be there. So what is it? Say Nyayanana. Nanu so Brahmana Puramitatra Swaswamitam Shashtirtam Hitva. So one meaning of Shashti Swaswami Hitva, giving up Brahma Shabda Mukhyata Svikartavya. So where Brahma should be interpreted in the primary sense as Param Brahma. Pratyarthasya prakrityartha apekshasya durvalyat. But Brahma is prakriti. And the sixth case is the pratyaya. So prakriti means substantive. And pratyaya means suffix. Between the two, substantive is more, is primary, and the suffix is secondary. So therefore, it is the primary thing that should control the meaning and not the suffix. That's what Mahasyakara's meaning is. Then the Pura Paksha says, no, Brahma Pakshe Pratyasa Niralammanatvam Eva. See, when you say Brahma, Brahmana Puram, Puram related to Brahma, then there is no Alambanam. What is the specific relationship? Jiva Pakshe Prakritya Alambanam Kathanchidasti. On the other hand, when you say Jiva, Jivasya Puram, then Jiva is definitely related to Puram. Tadarthasya Brahma Abheda. Then Jiva also can mean Brahma. So therefore, Jiva can be interpreted as Brahma also. By specific relationship, tatraha. Tasya Subhashyakara says, tasyapi asti purena anena sambandha upalabdhi adhisthanatvat. So Param Brahma also is related to his body because the body is the place of realization of Brahma. So body means the heart, or the space within the heart is where Brahman is realized. In that sense, Brahman is related to this body. Say Ratnabhava, Sharirasya Brahmana Tat Upalabdhisthanarupe Sambandhe Manava. So we don't restrict the sambandha as the Swaswami. It can be any sambandha. What is sambandha here? Shariyasya Brahmana sambandhe. How the body is related to Brahman is what? Tad upalabdhisthana tarupe sambandhe. That Shariya body, human body, is related to Brahman as the place of its realization. So there are other sambandha is there. If a general sambandha, if interpretation can be general sambandha, then we should not restrict sambandha to a particular one. That's what is meant, nirapekshena tat sapeksham madhyam. So, shastina brahmanapuram should be interpreted in a general sense as sambandha shasti. When this nirapeksha sambandha is applicable, the special sambandha of Swaswami is not to be imagined. Swaswami is an imagine, is someone you have to imagine particular sambandha. But generally is applicable, you should not go for particular. So where do you find that Brahmani can be realized in his body? Or that Brahman dwells in the body or meditated upon in his body and realized in the body? Where is the manam? Where is the pramana? So Bhashyakara quotes here the statements from other Upanishads. Saha etasmat jiva ghanat paratparam purishayam purushamikshade. Saha, who is saha vidvan? This comes from Prashna Upanishad. So in the fifth chapter of the Prashna Upanishad, where that is the description of upasana or meditation upon Omkara. So there also is krama, or this order is followed. That first comes dhyanam or meditation, and then comes jnanam of the shodashakala purusha. So the meditation Prashna Upanishad is presented in a very peculiar way. Omkara is three matras, akara, ukara, makara. So then the Upanishad sings the glory of Omkara. Then look, if somebody meditates on Omkara, with only one matra emphasis and one matra akara, then also akara stands for the Prasavi Loka and Rug Veda. So the ruchas of the Rug Veda come and take this upasaka to this world, meaning all the pleasures of this world. He meditates upon akara and ukara. The ukara stands for the Yajurveda and the intermediate world. So then the rucha of Yajurveda come and takes the upasaka to the Soma, the world of Soma, or Pitraloka. This is Soma Loka. And he meditates upon all the three matras, akara, ukara, makara. Then makara stands for Samaveda and Brahma Loka. Then this Samaveda, Madhruchas of Samaveda, they come and take him to Brahmaloka. So then verse is, Saha Samindra Vidwan Tri Matra Omkar Abhignaha. That meditator who meditates upon all the three matras of Omkara, Etasmat Jiva Ghanat Parat Param. Etasmat Jiva Ghanat Parat Param. The one that is superior to this Jiva, this Jiva Ghanam. So, Etasmat Jiva Ghanat Parat stands for one entity. What is this Jiva Ghana? The Hiranyagarbha is called Jiva Ghana. Hiranyagarbha Sarvesham Samsayanam Jivanam Atma Bhuta. Who is Hiranyagarbha? He is called the Antaryami or the indwelling self of all the living beings. Because Hiranyagarbha is the totality of all these sukshma sharira subtle bodies. And as subtle body, Hiranyagarbha dwells in all the living beings as their self. Because consciousness identified the subtle body is called the Jivatma. And Jivatma is self of this body, of this being. So Hiranyagarbha is the Antaratma of all the living beings. He is called Sutra, the one that connects everybody. So Linga Rupena Sarabhutanam Sai Antaratma. As a subtle body, Hiranyagarbha is the indwelling self of all the living beings. Tasmani Lingatmane Samhataha Sarve Jivaha. He is called Sutratma. Because just as in the thread, all the different pearls are strung. So also in the thread of Hiranyagarbha, all the living beings are strung. So it's called Sutratma. Therefore it's called the Jiva Ghana. Meaning that he is the totality of all the Jivas. So Etasma Jiva Ghanat. Jiva Ghana stands there for Hiranyagarbha. Jiva Ghanat Parat. Hiranyagarbha itself is superior. Paratparam, well, that is superior even to Hiranyagarbha. So, Sayetasmat, Jivaghanat, Parat, Param, Purishayam. So, that which is superior to even Hiranyagarbha. Parat, Param, Paramatmanam. Superior Hiranyagarbha is Paramatma. Where is Paramatma? Purishayam, Purusham, Ikshade. Ikshade, he realizes. Purusham, the Purna Paramatma, who is the Purishayam, who is indwelling in this city of the body. Because Purusha has entered in this body, city of the body. The whole purpose of entry or the Pravesha Shruti is because Paramatma is realized in this body. So, Bhashyakara's interpretation of the Pravesha Shruti in the Taittiriya Upanishad is, so, Yo Veda Nihitam Guhayam Parame Vyoman. Upanishad said, Yo Veda, one who realizes, Nihitam as placed in the Guha. Guha means what? The cave of the mind, the cave of the intellect. Parame Vyoman. In the Shuddha Antahkarana, the cave of the Shuddha Antahkarana, one who realizes Brahman as the very self. So therefore, Purishayam Purushamiksha. So that is the purpose of the Pravesha Shruti. That Brahman has entered this body. Therefore, Brahman needs to be realized in this body. In the heart, in the body. That's why one meditates and realizes. So that's how this Purishayam, Purusham, that Paratparam, the one that is superior to Hiranyagarbha, is Purishayam Purusham, is Purna Purusha who is dwelling in this body. Ikshate, he realizes that Paramatma as indweller of this body. Meaning that Paramatma is realizing his body, or the body is the Adhisthanam, is the location where the Paramatma is realized. Then second one, Sa ayam purusha sarvasu pushu purishaha ityadi shrutibhyah. So sa ayam purusha, say the tika, purushu shariresu. So sarvasu pushu purishaha. What a purushu? Pur also means the city. So purushu means shariresu, city, I mean all the bodies. Purishaya means again what? Puri Rudayashaya, one who dwells in the body. So this one who dwells in the heart, or the body, in all the bodies. So Purusha who dwells in the hearts of all the bodies, or in all the bodies. Therefore, Purusha is said to be dwelling in this body. And that is where the wise people realize him. Therefore, the human body is the place of realization of Parambrahma. In that sense, Parambrahma is related to this body as a place where it is realized. He is not the master of the body. Jiva can be master of the body. But Brahman also is related to this body because that is where Brahman is realized as a self. Says the Nyayanirna, Sarvasu Purushu iti Vyapadishya. So, Upanishad says, Sava ayam Purusha, Sarvasu Purushu Purishaya. So, Sarvasu Purushu iti Vyapadishya. For that Purusha is called one who is in all the cities. Purishaya iti Visheshanam. Then further he said Purishaya iti Visheshanam. Hrudaya Sambandha Vivakshaya. He is in all the body. So that is Sarvasa Purusha. Then Purusha also dwelling in the body. So where? Dwelling in the heart. In all the bodies, Param Brahma dwells in the hearts of all the bodies. So, ityadi shrutibhya ityadi adipadam yo veda nihitam guhaya ityadi sangrahartham. The other shruti says, yo veda nihitam guhaya. One knows Satyam Jnanam Brahman as dwelling in the heart. Cave of the heart. So therefore, Brahman is related to the body, and the Brahmapuram should be interpreted as the city which is related to Brahman, which is where Brahman is Param Brahman. Then says Ratnavara, Nanu, Brahma Shabdasya Jivepi Annadina Shri Buddhihetu Mukhyatvat. So Brahmanad Brahma Bruh Vruddhau. So that it brings about Vruddhi or growth. So Brahma Shabdasya Jivepi Annadina Shri Buddhihetu Mukhyatvat. So you know, the argument here was, what Brahman should be interpreted in primary sense, and then you should look at the relationship. So what Brahman means Param Brahman, so what's the relationship? Upalabdhi Sthanatvam. But the Purupakshi said, what Brahma can also mean Jiva in primary sense, because Bruhatvad, so Brahma Rudhi Artha if you take, it is Param Brahman. If you take the Yogi Vyutpatti Artha, or the derivative meaning then, Bruhatvad Brahman. So that it brings about the vruddhi or the growth, bruhi vruddhav. Bruhi vruddhav, so he says, jivevi annadina. So this jiva in fact is responsible for the vruddhi or the growth of this body because his prana, jiva prana dharana. The jivatma sustains the prana, so that sustains the body. And then this body consumes the food, and that's how the body grows. So Brahma as Jiva is responsible for the growth of the body. And therefore, Bruhatvat Brahma applies to Jivatma also. So Mukhyatvat. So word Brahma also can mean Jiva in primary sense, you know. Because you would take primary meaning of Brahma. You do Param Brahma as a primary meaning. Purupakshi says Jiva also is primary meaning in the sense of Bruhi Vruddha. Therefore, na shasthyartya kathanchid neya. Therefore, shasthyartha should be as applies to Jiva. And that is Swaswami Sambandha should be applied here and not just any relationship. Ittaha thavayate. So, Bhashyakara gives an alternate interpretation. Same thing Nyayendran also said, nanu sharira shairam annapana vyavaharanena brumhayati. So brumhayati iti brahma. What is sharira? Sharira bhava sharira jivatma. The jivatma also makes this body grow by annapana, etc. Itasun mukhyam brahmatvam. So in jiva, so brahma is in primary jiva, in primarily means brahma. Brahma means jiva rather. Tasya cha svakarmanachitattvat asadharanam shariram. And jiva is more related to the body than Brahman is because jiva has acquired this body through its own karma. Tatha cha prakriti pratyav jiva mukhyav. So prakriti is Brahma. That also means jiva. And pratyav is here the possessor. That also applies to jiva. So, Athava, then Vashyakara says, to this Vashyakara replies, Athava jivapure eva asmin brahma sannhitam upalakshade yatha sharagrame vishnahu sannhitah iti tadvata. Prasad Jivapura, all right. Take Jivapura as the city of the Jivatma, all right. The body is city of Jivatma. Even then also, so therefore Asmin. So Asmin, Brahmapura, Dharam, Pundarikam, Veshmana. So Brahmapura means this body belonging to Jiva, okay. Then also, Asmin, Brahma, Sannhita, Upalakshyate. Here also Brahman is is perceived directly. Sannidha upalakshade perceived, sannidha in proximate way. In this body also Brahman is perceived directly. Yatha shalagrama vishnu. So just as by meditating upon shalagrama one realizes Vishnu, so also by meditating upon dharakasha in this body one realizes Brahma. So, Shalagrame Vishnu Sannihita. Just as in Shaligrama, Vishnu is realized directly. So, also in this body, Brahman is realized directly. And therefore, even if the word Brahmapuram is interpreted as the city of Brahman or Jiva, then also the one that is realized is Brahman in this body. In that way also, Brahmapuram, so Asmin Brahmapure, applies to Brahman and not to Jiva. Says, Sharira sambadnam eva uttar hetubhya brahmana api sambadhyate. Sharira sambadnam eva veshma. So even this Veshma, the heart, is primarily related to Jivatma because Jivatma dwells in the heart. But that same heart, Uttarebhya Hetubhya Brahmana Api Sambadhyate. The same heart also is related, even though it is the dwelling place of Jiva, it is also related to Brahman as the place of realization. Drushtami Rājapure Maitra Sadma Ityartha. Just as a fellow called Maitra lives in the city of a king, So not only king lives in the city, Maitra also lives there. So even though this city belongs to Jiva Atma, he is a king, and since Brahman also can be the tenant or the indweller in that city, so that he can be related. So therefore, even if you interpret this Brahmapuram as the city of Jiva, then also this city is related to Brahma as the place of realization. Okay, same thing Ratnabhava said, Brahmayati Dehamati Brahma Jivaha. So which causes the body to grow. Tasvami ke pure hrudayam Brahma Veshma Bhavatu. In that city belonging to Jiva, that hrudaya is the dwelling place of Brahman. Even though Shiva is the owner of this city, Brahma, the heart is where Brahman dwells. Just in the city which owned by king, Maitra can live. So in the city, this body owned by Jiva, Brahman lives in the heart which is his dwelling place. Rajapare, Maitra, Sadmavat, same thing. So therefore also word Brahmapuram also need not mean Brahma means Jiva, it can mean Parambrahma. Then Ananda Phala Lingadapi Dhara Paramatma iti. Also, the meditation upon Dhara Akasha leads to Ananda Phalam. So meditation upon Jiva cannot lead to Ananda Phalam. Meditation upon infinite only can give infinite result. If Jiva is a limited entity like the tip of a golden stick or something like that, it cannot give infinite result. The fact that the meditation upon Dhara Akasha results into the infinite pleasure. Therefore also, Dhara Akasha should be Parambrahma and not Jivatma. another indicator remark, Anandaphala Lingada. So Uttarebhya, various lingas or evidences are there. Dhara Paramatma Tadyathaya, this Vashyakara says. Same thing, Nanyanadikincha Karahula Nityata Nivrutya Dhara Jnanasya Anandaphalatpashrutehe Dharasya Paratmamidi. Karahula Nityata Nivrutya. How the phala of a karma, any karma that you perform, the result is always anitya. So nityada nivrutya. First of all, Shruti says that the karma phala is anityam or perishable. Dhara jnanasya ananda phalatva shruti. Then it is said that the one who realizes the one dhara akasha, he gains infinite results. Therefore also dharasya paratvam. Therefore, Dhara Akasha should mean Paramatma, because then only you can get the infinite results. So, Tadyatha Bhashyakara says, Tadyatha iha karma chito lokah kshiyate evam eva amutra punya chito lokah kshiyate iti cha karmanam antavat phalatvam uktva. Athaya atmanam anuvidya vrajante etamsa satyan kaman tesham sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavate iti prakruta dhara akasha vijnanasya ananda phalatvam vadan Paramatmam asya sujade. Tadyatha iha karma chito loka kshiyate. Iha means in this world, what have you attained as a result of karma? Like serving a master. So there are servants who serve the king, or servants who serve the master. So that's how the karma used to be in those days. So just as a person who serves a king or a master, he is rewarded by the king. But whatever the reward be, is always going to be limited. Similarly, if you perform the karma, then serving the devatas. Anyo sau, anyo hamasmi iti. So, that devata is different, I am different. In that manner, when you worship the devatas, devatas will reward you with karma phala, but that is going to be limited, perishable. Yeh karma cha loka kshiyate eva meva amutra. So here the reward given by the king is limited, so there also reward given by devatas will enable you to go to surga, but there also it's a reward, result of karma, and that one is perishable. Kshiyate iti. Cha karmanam antavat phalatvam uktva. Shruti clearly said that the phalam, the result of karma or rituals, so the karma in terms of the service is limited. The karma in terms of ritual enables you to go to heaven, that also is limited. So antavat phalatvam uktva, the result of any action, whether it is laukika action or vaidika action, is going to be limited and therefore perishable. Athaya iha atmanam anuvidya vrajanti ye. On the other hand, those who depart from this body, having known the atma, itam satyan kaman, along with the, because the dharakasha also includes not only universe, but then all the kamanas and the kamya vishaya, the objects of pleasure also. Therefore, realization of dharakasha also includes the realization of all the desires and the fulfillment of all the desires and the desirable objects. So, ananda phalatvam so snute sarvan kaman sa brahmana vipasyata iti. As Brahman, that is the consciousness, he attains the, he experiences the result of all the desires. So, therefore, paramatmatmam asya suchayati. So, result of the knowledge of dharakasha is the same as the result that is the of the knowledge of paramatma. So, elsewhere, Taittiriya Upanishad says that knower of Brahma attains the result of experiencing all the desires together. Here also he said that he experienced all the desires together. That means that the one that is realized is Param Brahma. So Paramatmam, because the word Paramatma is not used. Or Brahmani Param Brahma is not used. That is all the discussion. So that's why we go for linga or evident chinha. All these chinhas only indicate Paramatma and not anybody else. So, paramātmatya sasya sūcayati. Says the Ratnavara, atha karamphaladvār karamphalād vairāgyānantaram. So, atha ye iha ātmāna anuvidya. Atha means what? Karamphalād vairāgyānantaram. So, first Shruti says how the result of karma is limited, is perishable. Then vairāgya. The result why, the reason why Shruti said this, tad yathaya karma chito loka kshiyate eva matra punya chito loka kshiyate, he is only to convey that the result obtained by karma is limited. So you should go over karma and upasana, because then only you get the Brahma loka and the limitless result. Therefore, creating vairagya in this person for the result of karma, because they are perishable and he wants something imperishable, that's how he is motivated to for the knowledge, jnanam. Here jnanam means upasana, it doesn't matter, but so karhola vairagya, asa means what? After vairagya, for karma phala. How do you get vairagya for karma phala? Because Shruti says that the result of karma, any karma phala, is perishable. And therefore the person who wants imperishable will be disillusioned, will be the karma phala. With karma. And therefore, iha. So, ye iha. Atmana anuvidya. He means what? Jiva dashaya. So, those upasakas, those meditators who realize Brahman as the self, or dharakasha, which is the self, while they are here. And then, etam sa sarvan kaman. In all the desires, all the desirable objects that are also included in dharakasha. So he realizes dharakasha along with all the kamanas. So what does it mean? So, iha jiva dashayam atmanam anuvidya. Anuvidya, anu means what? In keeping with. So anu means what? Jiva dashayam atmanam is dharam, dharakasam. Tadashitam se kama satya kama adi gunan. So satya kama, satya sangalva. So all the unfailing desires, unfailing will, also realizing that anuvidya, acharya upadesha, anuvidya, in keeping with the upadesha or instruction of the teacher. Anuvidya means what? Dhyanena, anubhuya. So realizing through meditation. So through meditation, this person realizes, even while he's in this body, realizes dharakasha and all the satya sakama, etc., which are in dharakasha. Ye, then this ye means what? So, vrajanti, those who depart, you know, vrajanti means what? Paralokam gacchanti. So those who depart, meaning go to the paraloka, brahmaloka. Etam satyam teshu sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati means what? Tesham sarvalokeshu anandam aishwaryam svechya sanchananadikam bhavadityartha. Sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo means sarveshu lokeshu anandam aishwaryam bhavati. They get the infinite glories, you know, of the overlordship in all the worlds. And means what? Svechya sanchananadikam. Just as a sovereign has, you know, he can move about at will in his territory, so also this upasaka can move about in all the worlds at his will. Means the result is infinite. And that can be only if the dharakasha is Paramatma. So, iti prakruta dharakasha vijnana vijnanasya. It in this manner, prakruta dharakasha vijnanasya. So understand that this meditation is upon dharakasha, because atmanu anuvidya, esha atma. So dharakasha is first described with atma, and then says realizing the atma, means they are realizing dharakasha. One gets infinite result, then dharakasha. So realizing dharakasha gives infinite result, then dharakasha should be Paramatma. So ananda phalatvam vadan paramatattvam asya suchayati. What is vadan? Iti acharya vedova uttaha. Who says this? This vakya comes from acharya or comes from Veda? Tadyathaya karmishto lokshiyate. Who says this? Are the acharya says that in the text or Shruti says that? Says Ratnavala, Dhare Uktalingani Anyatha Siddhani Tesham Tadantastha Gunatvadi Uktam Smaraitva Dushayati. Then the final point. Purupakshir said, it is not Dharakasha that is presented here as an object of meditation. It is something within that Dharakasha that is presented as the object of meditation. See, tasmin yadanta iti paravisheshanatvena upadanat. So, nasa atra dharasya akasha sanveshyatma vinyasita vijignyasita vyam jashruyate. Finally, the Purupakshi said, then, so, pundarikam veshma dharasmin antarakasha tasmin yadanta tananveshtavyam. So, what is within dharakasha? So, this was the thing. Tasmin yadanta that which is within that. So within what? If tasmin means hrudaya, then that which is within the heart is to be realized. If tasmin is akasha, because that dharakasha is immediately proximate, therefore, if tasmin dharakasha, then what is in dharakasha is to be realized. So this Upanishad is talking about realization of what? Anveshtavyam tadva vijignasitavyam. It should be realized and inquired into, should be realized. So what is it that is the object of inquiry and realization that is prescribed by the Upanishad? Is it what is in within the heart, that is dharakasha, or within dharakasha? So word tasmin can be interpreted as tasmin, so hrudayakasha, tasmin hrudaye, or tasmin dharakasha. So if tasmin is dharakasha, then dharakasha is not presented as the object of anveshanam and vijignasam, then it is what is within dharakasha is presented here as that which is to be inquired into and realized. So all the exercise that you are doing, that dharakasha is paramount, is useless, because dharakasha is not presented as the object of realization. It is what is within dharakasha is presented as the object of realization. What about that? So says, anveshatvadehe. No, sorry, here, one second, wait here. Dahare uktalingani anyatha siddhane. Uktalingani. The important linga is anveshtavyam vijignasitavyam. So that is to be inquired into and that is to be realized. So whatever is to be inquired into and what is to be realized is the primary subject matter here. Is it dharakasha or something within dharakasha? So Purupakshi says that the linga of anveshtavyatvam and vijignasitavyatvam, they do not apply to dharakasha, they apply to what is within dharakasha. So dhare uktalingani anyatha siddhani. What uktalingani? Anveshtavyatvam and vijignasitavyatvam. These lingas, they apply to somebody else and not to dharakasha. Tesham tadantastha gunatvadi uktam. Because they are to be, they pertain to what is within dharakasha. So this was said on the page 224. Tasmin, and so nachatra dharasya akashasya anveshatvam vijignasitavyatvam cha shruyate. Upanishad doesn't mean that it is dharakasha which is to be inquired into and realized. Tasmin danta idi para visheshanatvena upadanat. So para visheshanam, para means what? Antastham vastu, visheshanam means what? Adhara. So dharakasha is presented as the locus of that which is to be realized. So what is to be realized is located in dharakasha. And therefore, it is that which is to be realized and not dharakasha. We already said it, so that is reminded here. So, smaraitva dushayati. So what the Purvapakshi said, is brought to memory and then shows is refuted here. Yadapi Vashyakara says, Yadapi etaduktam na dharasya akasasya anveshtavyatvam vijignasitavyatvam cha shrutam paravisheshanatvena upadana dete. Bhashyakara repeats the same sentence of Purvapakshi. Yadvi eruduktam, and then what was stated by the Purvapakshi? Na dharasya akashasya anveshtavyatvam. This is not dharakasha which is to be inquired into and vijignasitavyatvam or realized. Just that is not what the Shruti, so Shruta means Shrutya Pratipadam. Shruti does not say that dharakasha is object of anveshanam and vijignasa. Then, paravisheshanatvena upadanat, they apply to what is within dharakasha. And therefore, anveshtavyatvam and vijignasatavyatvam apply to what is within dharakasha. And that's what you are saying, okay? That's what Nyayanin also said. Dharakasasya anveshatvatvadi siddhau tatra vicharaha. First of all, you have to prove that anveshatvam and vijignasatvam apply to dharakasa. Natu tadasti, but that's not the case. Tasmi anta, iti anta, antastha visheshana, visheshanat. So anveshatvam and vijignasatvam, anveshtatvam, anveshtavyatvam and vijignasatvam apply to what is within dharakasa. So then Bhashyakara says, Atra Brumaha. Alright, so to that, this is what we will say. Yadi Akashaha na Anveshtavyatvena Uktasya Yavanvai Ayam Akashaha Tavan Eshaha Antarude Akashaha Ityadi Akasa Swarupa Pradarshanam na upayujyeta. Iti akasha na anveshtavyatvena uktasya. If dharakasha is not presented by Shruti as what's to be realized, then Shruti says yavanvai ayam akasha tavanis antarudaya akasha. But then, as vast as this external space, so vast is dharakasha. Ityadi akasha swarupa pradarshanam. Subsequent passage in fact reveals what is this swarupa, what's the nature of dharakasha. Because the students raise the question that dharakasha is a small, insignificant space. What is there in there? Says, no, it's not insignificant. It's as vast as the external space. So, subsequent statement reveals swarupa, the nature of dharakasa, and not which is within dharakasa. So, tad antastham. So, it is dharakasa of which the swarupa is described later on, and not swarupa of what is within dharakasa. Yavanva ayam akasha tavanesha antarude akasha. So as vast as in magnitude is this external space, so vast in magnitude is the space within the heart. Iti akasha swarupa pradarshanam na upayujyeta. Then they should have described what is within the dharakasha. So you have to describe what is to be meditated upon. So swarupa, or the nature of what is to be meditated upon, is described by Shruti subsequently, where the dharakasha is described as vast and all-inclusive, and therefore that is to be meditated upon. Otherwise, if Shruti had intended that what is within dharakasha is to be meditated upon, then that should have been described. That's not that. Iti, alright. So, uttaratra akasha swarupa pratipadana anna. So, anupatya. So, this is arthapatti. Shruti would not have described the swarupa of dharakasa had it not been the object of meditation. So, arthapatti. Tasya he gnyetvam antas samayitai sahishtamiti. Deva tasya gnyetvam. The dharakasa is what is to be realized by whom? Antas samahitai, by those whose minds are concentrated within, by them, is dharakasa which is to be realized. So, atra brumaha. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow and complete this. Om purnamadah purnamidam purnat purnamudachyade Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti. शांति 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 नमः हरि ओम।